but he's become my eyes to see, the strength to climb, my grief to bear, the Savior lives inside me there. In your love I find release, a haven from my unbelief. Take my life and let me be a living prayer, my God, to thee. In these trials of life I find another voice inside my mind. He comforts me and bids me live inside
like only yesterday we fell in love, just barely old enough to be sincere. Back then I thought I loved you all I could, but I've grown to love you more through the years. Through the years I've had you to keep me happy, hand in hand we face tomorrow with no fears. Side by side we've walked the road of life together, step has drawn us closer through the years. Now we've raised all our children and they're gone. Once again, you and I are all alone. But I never will be lonely while you're here, 'cause we've got a love that's lasted through the years. Through the years I've had you to keep me happy, gathered, and each step has drawn us closer through the years, and each step has drawn us closer through the sins.
and grant him a place of happiness and light and peace in the kingdom of your glory, forever and ever.
Jesus, your Lord of life and death, Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to eternal life, Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. God Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Jim, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you all to be seated tonight and to listen to the reading.
Isaiah from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will be beautiful and very good for their altars. And destroy and ravage all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tear from our cheek. He will take away the people's shame and every honor. For the Lord has said so. That day, that will be said, see, this is your God and whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hope we exalt and we rejoice that he saved us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Various catering venues were done through the years.
The word gaiety itself means what our gatherings here is all about. It's coming together. Gaiety is having crack together, sharing stuff in common. So it's a wonderful thing here. The wonderful word gaiety means the gaiety, together, togetherness. That's what it's all about. So we're very fortunate to be able to share our faith and our love and our Christian belief in life after death. And to share that among ourselves and strengthen it by sharing it, but also to lend it in a spiritual, supportive way to Cathy and all of Jim's family. Now, Jim was born and reared in Grange before he met Cassie and emigrated to Moress, about 2 fields away from there he was brought up. And seems to me that apart from one or two townland names that are common or image, everything else is Grange, so we'll take that as a given. But the word Grange itself is a very important, very historical word. There are very few regions of Ireland that doesn't have an area called the Grange. The Grange was an expanse of land that was handed over to a religious community so that they could grow grain. So it was like the food belt of the local area. And be it monks or whatever the religious institution was, they would have farmed that parcel of land so that they could produce crops, not only to feed themselves, but to feed strangers and the poor that might pass by, and also to help to feed the local community. And it was mostly grains for the making of bread that was being cultivated. And when you think about it, you know, bread, we talk about the bread of life, the bread, the gifts for the altar, the bread of life, the bread that is transformed from just earthly bread to the miracle of the transformation of that bread and the wine into the water and the blood of Christ. And bread also is very much at the heart of family kitchen, the gathering around, and the breaking and sharing of bread together. We use the word companion. The word companion. Right in the middle of the word companion is the old Latin word for bread, panis. Companion. A companion is someone you share bread with. Someone you share bread with. At Holy Communion, in the religious sense, we're all companions with Christ. Because at the Eucharist, at the Mass, we share the bread of the Eucharist, the living bread that has come down from heaven. And that is the very bread that we will share today as we celebrate this funeral Mass for Jim. But a chainsaw here, and the chainsaw massacre. If I was thinking of things, you know, maybe that represented Jim and all his skills and stuff, maybe a hammer or chisels or a chainsaw, you know. But it struck me yesterday when I was leaving the house after the lake that Jim's skills and abilities working with his hands, I'm told, if you don't know already, but apparently their house was the first privately built house in Inch. Very posh. But I reflect on the fact that when you walk into a house, if it was a builder or somebody who knew what he was about to build, they built the house to see it. High ceilings, tall people love high ceilings. Walls that actually do meet at right angles. Not just DIY programs on TV, but actual walls that make the brand expansiveness. You know, Jim had a major share in the building of that house. I'm sure a lot of people around here, you knew that Jim was the go-to guy if you needed help in construction. Jim was your man. We give that very hands-on earthly experience, been able to do that. He also was a fisherman. Informed reliably that the late Father Hugh Carlin absolved him so that there was no poaching. See how you can bend the rules. And just a very earthy, down-to-earth man who enjoyed the crack, enjoyed the Canadian, and was a very important friend and major person in this community here, especially in the community of Inch. And I kind of thought too that with all his skills, chainsaw apart, all the things that Jim did in life like that, it's very biblical. Think about it. Who were the people that Jesus called to be his disciples? They were people who worked with their hands. They were fishermen. They were people who made clay pots. People who used material to make tents and other things as well. Utensils. Very practical, down-to-earth stuff. And if the pandemic and all that happened around the taught us anything, is the world can survive without people who do not get their hands dirty and who create things and build things, construct things, and put things together. We should never underestimate that. And it strikes me then, if Jim were living in the time of Christ, if he certainly wasn't in the disciples' first team, he was certainly on the bench. And, you know, he used all that talent that he had, to just do things to support the family, to put bread on the table, and along with Cassie, to rear their own children, and then to be grandparents to their children as well. That's a wide lot of stuff. That's a wide lot of stuff, you know, for one man to do in life. And you just do it not in a huge, big, obvious way, but just doing the best you can with the experiences in life that have been given to you, and just to do it with a heart of gold. So that's Jim. That's the Jim that sadly my God has called for himself. But as we gather here in prayer for Jim, we hope that even now he's gathered around that banquet feast in heaven, and that he has been given the place in heaven that God has set aside for him. I often these days also think when I read this gospel passage that Martha and Mary, the two sisters, they were absolutely heartbroken when their brother had died. And they were cousins of Jesus. And when Jesus eventually came along 3 or 4 days after the funeral, they were a bit annoyed and said, if he'd been here, her brother wouldn't have died. But Jesus tried to point out to them later on in the Bible, if he didn't die now, he wasn't going to die at some stage. It was going to happen. And there's no good time or best time or time when we're all ready for someone we love to die. It just doesn't happen that way. So today we reassure ourselves with our faith. And when Jesus said to Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. I'm in charge of life and death. Do you believe that? Martha just turns and says, yes, I believe that you are the resurrection and the life, and that you will bring our loved one to heaven. So that's our message today for Catholic Roman Catholic, that Jesus is the resurrection and the life, that death is not the end, and that God, who is a jealous God, wants us to be with him in heaven. So we pray today that God may grant to Jim eternal rest, may his soul and the souls of all the faithful in heart, I invite you now to stand for prayer. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
Lord, hear us.
brother Jim Boyle, the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he will be raised up on the last day. Glory to us.
Glory to us.
And for Jim, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, may he now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now we bring the gifts of bread and wine to the altar. And the bread and wine, of course, will be transformed during Mass into the body and blood of Christ. Gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you." this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, her Pope, Donald, her Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Jim, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in the death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who fall asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Save us from man, born in the time of the king, we dare to say. Safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on your sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. the distribution of Holy Communion, we will do this side of the chapel first, begin at the seat and work our way back, and then we'll come over to the second chapel.
Children that you called, smoke and a
incense rising up like our prayers to heaven for Jim this day. Trusting in God, we pray together for Jim, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Jim again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Response to the psalm, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ who called you take you to himself, may angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Jim, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ, and we are with you and with our brother forever. In peace now, let us take our brother Jim to his place of rest.
Bring flowers of your rest, bring the blossoms of from the garden into death, and inside and deep, are the large stars glowing, are the land voices telling the praise of the loveliest flower of the bed. Blossoms today, Queen of the Angel and Queen of the May. Oh Mary, we crown thee with blossoms today, Queen of the Angels and Queen of the May. Sing
we'll meet again, my friends, somewhere down the line. Who knows where or when, another place, another time. We'll share a few old songs and memories on my mind. Yes, I know we'll meet again, my friends, somewhere down the line. We'll meet again, my friends, somewhere down the line. Who knows where or when, another place, another time. We'll share a few old songs and memories on my mind. Yes, I know we'll meet again, my friends, somewhere down the line. Another show is over, another day gone by, with good friends all around me. My, how the time does fly. It's hard to find the words I want to say, but friends, I'll try. God bless you all and keep you till we meet again, goodbye. We'll meet again, my friends, somewhere down the line. Who knows where or when, another place, another time. We'll share a few old songs and memories on my mind. Yes, I know we'll meet again, my friends, somewhere down the line. Another place, another time. We'll share a few old songs and memories on my mind. Yes, I know we'll meet again, my friends, somewhere down the line.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Our brother Jim has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother Jim. Together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. We read in sacred scripture, "Come, you whom my Father has blessed, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world." Prayer of blessing over the grave. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection even as it claims our mortal body. Grant that our brother may sleep here in peace until you awaken him to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then he will see you face to face, and in your light will see light and know the splendor of God. For you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Because God has chosen to call our brother Jim from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our brother Jim to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise up his body on the last day. Dear friends, in reverence let us pray to God, the source of all mercies. You raised the dead to life, give to our brother eternal life. Lord, hear us. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Jim, and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, hear us. Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Jim. Let our faith be our consolation, and eternal life our hope. Lord, hear us. We pray for all who are buried in this cemetery. May their suffering be lessened, may their joy be increased, may the light of glory shine on them, and may they rest in peace. Lord, hear us. With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Loving God, from whom all life proceeds, and by whose hand the dead are raised again, though we are sinners, you wish always to hear us. Accept the prayers we offer in sadness for your servant Jim. Deliver his soul from death, number him among your saints, and clothe him with the robe of salvation to enjoy forever the delights of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Bow your head and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. May the prayers of Mary, the Mother of God, who stood by the cross as her son was dying, help those who mourn for Jim and accompany all of us in our time of need. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. May his soul, the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry for banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn thou, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion on the cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. May the divine assistance remain always with us, and may the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We shuffle around the beach to the beat of
shooting, shoot the donkey, comply with the law. For in Yonkers, there in Yonkers, and the hear his e-haw. Now the sandwich, this is language, and the tea in the pot. Now the flame, the truck is drying, now the weapon is hot.
Yes, we're on up today to the great USA. We're heading for work in the town of New York. With our crowds and slaves, we forget all our things. I wish you a great to the beat of the day.
Oh, thank you.